Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is a little bit before 9 o'clock a.m. August 17th, 2016. It is Wednesday, to make sure. And I am still going to talk about Ummati Muhammad. Ummati Muhammad. See, again, nothing random. Everything happened and is gonna happen, and by Hezbollah Shaitan. It always has been the case, and this is our deen. This is deen of Allah. Okay, sunnah of Allah. I am going to talk about my particular case. Because I was there, I am here, living the experience and dealing with it, and alhamdulillah, I'm enjoying every second of it, alhamdulillah. Okay. It's so much to remember and talk. The brain is so much dirty laundry against Hezbollah Shaitan. It's stupid. Summum bukmun umyun fahum la yafqahoon. Dumb, deaf, and blind. I noticed that very vividly because it started to be a life experience for me right after the end of 2007 when I decided, actually a little bit before that, I noticed that and I knew what was going on since I was 16 or even younger. Okay. But I started fighting back right after the beginning or end of 2007. Okay. And then I discovered the weakness of Hezbollah Shaitan. Inna kayda shaitani kana da'ifa. Okay. Right after I filed a complaint against Fairway Ford first, and then Archstone, Placentia Place apartment complex, and River Bend also, Archstone. What do you call it? Archstone, River Bend, I think it's River Bend. Your banana. Okay. And then Western National Management. They own half of California. It's a corporation. Apartment complexes and management companies. Okay. That was it. That's all she wrote. I'm glad that this happened because this is how I provoke corporate America to come and be dragged and wipe the floor with their stupid. Okay. Now, poor state of California fall for it. And it's, oh man, no, we can't have Mohammed Shaban do that. Explodes with America and, because, you know, they are probably American. So the state of California took the bait, really. Wow. Now, the federal government got stuck in the middle. I love the federal government always have and always will. Why? Because the feds, they really try to do, there is another one here. There is one here, right there. Okay. So the feds are going by the book. They're very cautious. And I, again, I found out the day of when I got out of the, my invitation expired. Spend some time with the homies. May 23rd, 2010, and I just got out on May 19th, 2010, got out of the field, I see. And then supposed to be the hearing for my social security case. Bender and Bender was the attorney back then. He didn't do nothing. But anyway, this is. So when I went to there, I said, I don't know. And the attorney said, they sent a young attorney with me, lady. And she said, oh, well, we don't know. I said, okay, I withdraw because I'm not, you don't know what to do. You're supposed to be the attorney, have it. So now I filed for an appeal on that hearing because I didn't really go with the hearing. And it took a year and some, always takes a Social Security a year. Appeal? Oh, okay. We're busy. A year to two. And then from there, it takes another year to two, and then from there, until you get old and you die. Take the pocket, and then they burn you. First, they sell all the organs. Okay. To Loma Linda, Hall of Fame, Hall of Shame. To the filthy and not rich that they think they have a right, mostly gay, and again I don't have any preferences, or everyone has the right to do whatever, it's in their own little body there. Calm me out. But anyway, they sell people organs, and I suspect, I allege, that something happened to Hamza. Murder to him, if he is, and took everything out and as we know, I'm a local state is involved, the federal government, the FBI, insurance companies, corporate America, they all after. Because what I brought to the attention of the federal government. Not only that, many times I ask, if the federal government is not doing anything, the Department of Injustice is not doing anything, let's bring our concerns and our complaints to Amnesty International or the UN, or some because everyone telling me who did what and when. And we're not committing all these crimes against the masses. Everyone, fraud and kill and rape and everything. And when you talk like this, you are very, you want me to shoot you right then. The terrorist. Okay. Yes. So when I brought that to their attention, when I protested, they went, no, that's all she wrote. And it's County of Orange, still took the bait. Oops, stupid. Okay. From now on, didn't quit, didn't get tired, because this is what we are. We are Ummati Muhammad. We enjoy jihad, struggle against evildoers, against Hizb al-Shaytan, against the Sahibiyya al-Arabiyya, international Zionist terrorist organization that's terrorizing everything and everywhere. And they thought that they would be victorious, declaring war against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. Let's stay within the last, since 2015, Riverside, maybe, because I am in Riverside now. I'm not Delaware, Riverside, California. The Inland Empire, i.e. rented from 4226 11th Street near downtown Riverside, 11th and Brockton, from Sam Arbakov or Arbakov or whatever it is, Iranian fella. And you know what's going on, I call the weatherization, I call the community action partner. Riverside, you know, everybody knows. And I said, you know, it is to save energy. I called the Heritage Society or the Heritage Community Society, whatever, to preserve the old buildings, you know, Victorian old Riverside, whatever. $250,000. That org, that fraud, and I told this Sam that you can get this building to be restored and everything, renovated, everything, but for this money, you can get up to $250,000 from Riverside Heritage Society, whatever it is. Google it. And you can take care of your tenants. Lady lives downstairs, I'm not gonna say the names, roaches and all, it's unbelievable. And then I went to the city, talked to the mayor, and called enforcement, the fire department, and board of supervisors, and everywhere. And the senator office in the state building, don't know what's the name of the senator, I don't care for them anyway, because they are a bunch of corrupted gay fellas. But they continue to commit the crimes and they think that they have the right. Okay? So become homeless again. That was my housing. Paid by my own social security or disability. And also, it's the income of the funding for Institute of Southern American Muslims, which is a non-profit organization. So all of this, someone stealing the money from the Institute of Southern American Muslims, because this is I am taking care. I'm supposed to get these funds, not only from the amateur ones, but all the programs that are supposed to be, because we are a 501c3 nonprofit organization incorporated in 2013, April 2013. So everything is kosher, everything is neat. Instead of California, they just said, oh, well, okay, Board of Equalization, resale tax, oh, no. No, Mohammed Shabon, in the city of Safran, the American Muslim, I don't know. You're terrorists. Pink slip? Oh, no, it's not going to be an issue to Institute of Scotland or Mohammed Shabon. It's not, we don't. For the government? Oh, no, you keep talking about IRS and you pay taxes and you want to. Oh, no, Mohammed Shabon, no. Yeah, you're not. As stupid as that, nothing is honored when it comes to Institute of Scotland and American Muslims. Because from the get-go, they knew that we are sincere. We are doing the work. We're not only talking and taking the money and embezzling in people's names and keeping them in the status quo, keeping them in the dump that we are working in chaos, continue to commit the crimes against them. Crimes. Now, homelessness again, I learned when I was in Santa Barbara, seeing in California, and I've been within the social services, myself and my children, since 2007 on and off. Actually, before that, because Hannah, Suzanne, and Sumaya, they moved with me in 2006, and then I had to get Medicare and all that. Right? Food stamps and all. I don't know why I went to there, but homelessness. Safe Harbor. So they give you a spot to park your car or van or RV, your vehicle, and that's legal from the social services to be your home. As long as you have current tags and insurance and everything is, you don't trash the place, you keep it nice. Okay? That's the law. This is a law, right? Now, there is places also that you can pay, and you have to remove your vehicle and you can sleep in, But you could also park it legal, like parks and like Santa Barbara in the harbor parking lot, and sneak in and sleep, and there's no problem. They can't come and tell you, oh, you can sleep in your vehicle, you can sleep in your vehicle anyway. This is our laws, this is our country, this is US, and whether within the state constitution, or within the federal institution of the United States of America, that is respected and is kept in this country as great as the leader of the free of supposedly uncivilized world until now. Well, until 30 some years ago. Right? Because dismantling in the Quran, it took them like close to 40 years to get to as bad as we are now. This is it. So when when Abu Abdullah, supposedly to be an imam, he said that he's a judge too, he has Hassan Sahu and they offer him a school in New York, Cornell. A scholarship to be a homegrown imam and mufti. Embezzling money and throwing, fighting over food and, you know, calling people in words. He said that he has the FBI in his pocket, back pocket, not the front. And Mohammed Chabon is a terrorist and he's very concerned about people's safety, especially females, women, that they come to the mosque because Mohammed Chabon is a terrorist. And his son goes to Vegas with another woman he's married, man, and he gets someone, gashes his head with some, and then domestic violence case, and he's telling me that my son Hamza Kito, Allah rahmu, he's recording me. So everything has been happening. It's not random or what you apply for. Who said what? Everything well planned. I'll tell you why. Because a little bit over a year ago here in Riverside, I was in Garden Grove doing a Jum'ah prayer, and the imam that delivered the sermon was an FBI agent. And the sermon theme was about, we have to go back like Elijah Muhammad, the Nation of Islam, did. He brought that deal. We still have, you know, to go. That's how it started with the Islam here now within the United States of America. Now we have to follow the footsteps there. So calm down and just keep smoking the good hashish and getting high and getting drunk and getting bored, and everything's gonna be all rosy and everything. But rock with them and if they get a green card. Making a mockery of our deen. So I made a video and I said, I wanted the CIA, the FBI to get our religious institute. I knew that for so long that Muslim Siddiqui is a CIA agent. Went to Azhar, you know, to get his speak Arabic so he can work for the CIA within the United States of America. I knew that that's been happening by Saudi Arabia before. Saudi Yin, King and Calibs and Fats and all, for a long time, been controlling all this NSA and care and don't care, and Islamic this and Islamic that, North America, Europe, England, here and there, all like Wizarat al-Awqaf from us in Egypt, the Ministry of Awqaf, Ministry of Religion. Yeah. This is the politics that everyone is ignoring and saying, who did what? The rabbit dummy, the DK green card. Amit Chabon is a terrorist, same Berendino. The shooting, the 9/11, the first one was there over Scotland, Libya, or maybe before that, Abu Nidal, all of this. And the United States government, the FBI and the CIA, they go into the wrong clowns. Those are a lot less than little insects. Okay? Because they have no pride, they have no dignity, they have no deen, they have nothing. They like to be like this. Right? So please, urge you by the United States of America government to look into who they are going to help them to control the whole globe and select Ummati Muhammad. I'm not gonna con you, cheat you, because La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They're not gonna snitch in each other, they are not hoodwinks, they are not scumbags. They are Ummati Muhammad, Ummati Muhammad, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Our forefathers, we don't get bought, we don't compromise, we don't get intimidated, we are our Ummati Muhammad. We are Ummati Muhammad. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So for the recent incidents that has been happening, and breaking into my RV and taking things and vandalizing, cutting the city police, San Bernardino, or Riverside, or wherever, you should watch out, because this is not right. So when they go through people under the bus, because their own pennies that they're getting, committing crimes against everyone and everything, selling our deen, telling us that this is the way that we have to go, please, just to make sure to know all of this. And I'm willing to, you can ask me, call me anytime, come and take me to, I'll give you everyone and what they do, because this is our deal. This is our deal. And making a bad images and seeing all of this, it's our responsibility to bring it to the attention of the government that this is not Islam, this is not our deal. Islam fought all of this, because La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, Deen Allah. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. Right, so please, again, gotta go, but I just wanted to make this, I made a video for a location. The crime scene. And now I'm making this from my federal office, Starbucks, okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restore mercy on the humanity. And for the FBI again, please, I need to know what happened to my wife and myself. Just qada'ullah. It's qada'ullah. But I have the right to have the right to know. What happened to these two individuals? Okay. Jennifer Metz and Siobhan and Hamza Muhammad Chabin. Right? Thank you. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.